Oh my gosh, guys. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to Too Much Tech. And today, honestly, I feel a little bit overwhelmed. Like, I've been thinking about it. I'm like, holy crap. Like, I have so much stuff. Even, like, just keyboards. Like, I have, like, this freaking... Alright, so I got a Black Widow Elite. I already did this review. So that's done. I did that like a couple months ago. But I've been so busy like the past like couple months. I took a little break because like my content was suffering a little bit. We couldn't have that. I was like, no, I gotta take a break. I gotta reanalyze what I want to do. Blah, blah, blah. But in the meantime, we still got Too Much Tech that we gotta review. Like now, I'm reviewing this Huntsman right now during this video. So I need to hurry up and review that keyboard. And then on top of that, like we got so many keyboards just like here that I still need to review. I got my Ducky keyboard coming sometime this month. This room was like super duper dark, so let me turn these lights on real quick. So like I still got this K95 Platinum RGB that I still gotta review. So I gotta do this one at some point, probably during the next, I don't know, probably during the next week or so. And we also got the SteelSeries Apex 750 that we have to review. Yeah, and it's just been like really, really crazy. I've been like kind of busy, kind of taking a break, but now I'm like back to it. And it's like, bro, like you got too much stuff to review. What are you gonna do? When are you gonna do it? I don't know. How are you gonna edit it? How are you gonna have time for all that stuff? I'm like, bro, whew. I think what I'm gonna have to do, I'm gonna just shoot a bunch of V-roll in one day. And then over the course of like the next couple weeks or so, I might just do some more videos in like this format. Just pick up the camera, throw some lighting on, and just talk about it. Because honestly, like a lot of these keyboards nowadays, they're all like really, at least the ones that I'm reviewing, they're all like really good, except for one. And I'll get to that in a second. But yeah, so you kind of can't go wrong with a lot of keyboards nowadays. So it's like, I feel like I just gotta review them, talk about the pros, talk about the cons, and different stuff to look out for so that you feel like you really got the right one that you're looking for. Especially when we're talking about high-end keyboards too, because some of them, like the one I'm about to review right now, are kind of stupid. I'm not even gonna lie, and they're kind of not really worth it. So let's get into that. So the one that we're going to talk about today is the Razer Huntsman Elite. And honestly, this keyboard is kind of disappointing, I'm not going to lie. One, is disappointing because it's expensive, and two, it kind of lacks like some of the features that the Black Widow has, and it's, to me, it's not okay, especially because it is really expensive and it costs more than a Black Widow Elite. So you would think that it would have a couple features that the Black Widow Elite has. And then there's also like a couple nitpicks that I have with the keyboard too that kind of make the extra price not worth it. So number one, the keyboard is loud as heck. Now Razer has, like, at this point now they have four different keyboard switch types. So one, you got the green, orange, and yellow switch types. Those are the regular mechanical keyboard switch types. So the green ones are like the really, really loud ones that I have here on my Black Widow Elite. So super loud. And then the orange ones are the ones that I had on my old Black Widow V2. And those were much quieter. They were a lot like Cherry MX Browns. And then you have the yellow switches that are like super linear. When it bottoms out, it doesn't give you like a real tactile feel, but it's a lot quieter than the greens for sure. And then we got the purple Razer switches, which are like the opto mechanical switches. Basically, there's like a little laser and you break the little laser beam light, and then it just sends a signal to actuate the switch, and it's supposed to be like really, really fast. But like these switches are like super loud and it's kind of annoying, I'm not gonna lie. And I don't love how loud it is. So that's number one, it's loud as heck. And I really can't tell the difference between this switch and the green switch other than the sound. They sound slightly different, but they're both really loud. Just listen to it real quick. Now, again, like I was saying, as far as performance difference, the switches are supposed to be a lot faster, and I don't really play like a super high level or anything, so I don't really think that I would really notice the difference. Like, we're probably talking the difference between like Cherry MX Browns and Cherry MX Speeds, and you know, it's probably a little bit. I don't really think it's that noticeable, but maybe if you're playing at like a super high level, you would probably notice the difference a little bit better than me. Now, I do like the RGB light strip that goes around the entire keyboard and also around the magnetic wrist rest. The only problem that I have with the lights is that when you elevate your keyboard with the included, like the little two-stage stands, if you put it at the highest one and then try to connect the magnetic wrist rest, sometimes the lights, they just kind of glitch out because the magnets that deliver the power are like really, really touchy and they don't always work perfect. And it's kind of weird and it's really annoying. Like when you see it, like it's kind of flickers a little bit. I can't really get it to capture on video, but I've seen it happen. Like I just come home and I see the keyboard and the wrist rest just like flickering and it looks kind of stupid. It hasn't been doing it recently. Like right now, if you look at it, it's fine, but I noticed it before and I was not in love with it. Now, a couple missing features from the keyboard. So if you look on the left side of the Black Widow Elite, you'll have a USB port as well as a headphone jack, and those two are really helpful because you don't have to always run your SD card or your flash drive or just like an accessory you want to plug in real quick, or your headphones or your wireless mouse dongle. You can just have it be really, really close, plug into the side of the keyboard, but not on the Huntsman Elite. Now, I don't have the regular Huntsman. I don't know if that's a feature that, you know, is on the regular Huntsman or not, but those two ports are missing on the Huntsman Elite. And it's kind of annoying. I feel like they should be in the back or something. Like, I get it, you know, you got the RGB light running around, but you know, you could, I don't know, maybe put it in like the bottom of the base or something on the side or on the back or something of the sort. You know what I mean? At least, bare minimum, the USB port or the headphone jack should be there. Maybe not both, but at least one of them. But honestly, I don't see any reason why you couldn't have both of them there. I get it, the lights and stuff, RGB. Oh, I get it. I really do. But what about the functionality that is included with some of your keyboards that also cost a lot less? Now, I do like the placement of the media keys, the little rotary dial, but we have a problem with the rotary dial. Like, this is after like maybe 6 months of ownership. You spin the rotary dial and sometimes the volume doesn't work. You just have to keep going and keep going and keep going, and the volume, it gets stuck. And it's like, if you try to turn something down real quick, it doesn't always work. It's really annoying. That's not a problem that I've had on my Black Widow Elite, but on the Huntsman Elite, I did notice it, and it's really annoying, and I don't appreciate that because it's $200. Like, it's a lot of money on a keyboard. So like, I don't really feel like these kind of issues should have happened. Now, like I said, this is like a 6 month type ownership video, and we've had it ever since it first came out. So I don't know, maybe it's just because it was like a first wave of units or whatever, but it's just really annoying that something like that happened on a high-end keyboard. Probably just gotta send it to Razer, Best Buy or something so they can replace it. But still, like, I don't really think that's kind of good for longevity. So I don't know about that one. Now, Razer always does a pretty good job with fit and finish. Like, I like the metal top plate and the keycaps feel nice. The switches feel good, even though they're loud as heck. And overall, it is a pretty nice feeling keyboard, but it's not the most comfortable keyboard to game on. I feel like that's just because the angle of the wrist rest is not something I'm used to. I'm more used to the Black Widow Elite style of wrist rest, where it's angled, then it's a little bit more ergonomic, where this one is just kind of flat. Cause I play with my keys angled at me, so like my hand is kind of like this, but the wrist rest is flat. So like my hand, my wrist is just kind of like sitting on top of it, and my hands are going like this at almost like a 90 degree angle, and it's not really the most comfortable to me. So I feel like that's where the Black Widow Elite kind of wins in my book. And honestly, when I say Black Widow Elite, I mean the Black Widow Elite, the newest version, or the Black Widow V2, which you can probably find on sale for pretty cheap. And you can also like get different switches depending on who you order it from. Maybe Amazon. Maybe I'll see if I can find some Amazon links of the Black Widow V2, because that's actually like one of my favorite gaming keyboards. I don't know why I never made a review of it while I had it, but I probably should have, because at times I still like that one a little bit better than the Black Widow Elite that I have right now. But yeah, that was a good keyboard too. Kind of got sidetracked right there, but the Huntsman, I'm not gonna lie, is it worth $200? Not really. It's just missing too much stuff. And recently, like, I've been updating my Razer Synapse, and the RGBs have not really been working correctly, and it's just a whole stupid mess right now. Like, Razer Synapse, the more and more that I use it, the longer I've used it, and like, I just don't want to redo my presets because they take forever to do. But it's so annoying, and I'm kind of getting over it. I really am. So Yeah. So if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like. Subscribe if you guys are new. Be sure to turn on those post notifications. That way you know whenever I upload a new video. We're getting really close to 1,000 subscribers. If you are shopping for any of the products that I mentioned during this video, be sure to use our Amazon affiliate links down below. It helps out the channel. And also follow me on all my social medias like my Instagram, my Twitter, blah, blah, blah. I got those linked below as well. And yeah, if you guys have any questions, feel free to DM me on social media. I usually reply pretty quick, or just drop a comment. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one.